trial could be months away yet. My family is sending me a lawyer, but, well, they haven't found Megan yet.
What about the letter she wrote you?
It was a forgery. I wrote it myself.
How come you didn't tell us that?
Well, you know, I thought someone might talk to the screws.
You trying to say one of us had lag?
Oh, well, that's possible, isn't it? Don't forget someone bashed you and set me up for those robberies.
That's right. And the same person might think of lagging.
And who might that be?
I don't know, B. But if I knew, I'd tell you.
Well, you'd better. Because I don't like things going on that I don't know about. They might just cut across my plans.
You mean the escape?
I mean the escape. And if I hear you mention it again, I'll ram one of those coat hangers down your throat.
Well, I wouldn't say anything. But I'd like to help. If they can't find Megan, I might need to get out myself.
What's going on here? Griffin?
Nothing.
All right, everybody, outside. It's recreation. Not you, Griffin.
Now, what was going on?
I told you nothing.
That's the second time I've found Smith practically standing over you. You told Mrs. Davidson you were in danger.
Oh, that was just something to say.
It might help us and you, Griffin, if you told the same story twice in a row. All right, outside.
Back already, Smart. What happened? Are you working the streets during the day now?
I haven't been arrested. I came back to get something that was pinched.
Who stole it?
One of your screws. A cigarette case. I had it when I came in and now it's gone.
You signed for everything when you left.
Yeah, well, I didn't check the list, did I?
Would you get Smart's property list, please?
Oh, g'day, Anne.
No talking, Griffin.
She been arrested again?
No, she's accusing us of stealing some of her property.
Come along, Griffin.
There's no cigarette case listed here.
Well, I had it.
It's not on the list when you signed in, and it's not on the list when you signed out. Obviously, you lost it somewhere else. I suggest you call the police. I'll escort Smart off the premises. Now, come on.
You were a bit hard on her, don't you think?
Maybe. I've been wondering about her and about you being set up and my bash on the head have all happened since she arrived.
You don't think she's responsible, do you?
Don't know yet. She didn't show much spine when I heavied her. Still, that could be an act.
What are you going to do with her?
Set her up. Involve her in something, and if the screws find out about it, then we'll know it's her.
Who did that?
Sorry, Miss Bennett, it was an accident.
I bet it was, Gaffney. Now, I'm going to be reporting this to the governor.
Ah, good shot, Margot.
Outside, Smart.
Looks like you're in trouble, Margot.
I could cope.
Give it back! Give it back! Unless you're playing, get out of the way.
That must be where the cellar connects up with the storm drain. See, it runs right down to the river.
Yeah.
What'd the note say?
That there'd be a truck waiting where the map was marked with a cross.
Well, we're all set then.
Yep. All we have to worry about now is getting you four down that manhole. And hoping the screws don't find out.
Yes. Oh, yes, Mr. Gillespie.
I've just received notification of your decision to have a pianist at the pantomime.
That's correct.
And this pianist will be visiting the prison three times in the preceding week.
For rehearsals.
Do you think that's wise? I mean, musicians are such unreliable types. So many of them involved in the drug scene and so on.
Mrs. Hammond has been coming to Wentworth to accompany church services for as long as I can remember.
I'm sure she never takes anything more dangerous than a strong cup of tea.
Well, then there's the question of payment. I assume she will be paid.
Yes, from the recreation fund. That's set aside for craft materials, books, things like that. The women are prepared to forego that for a good cause.
What the women see as a good cause and what I see as one may not necessarily be the same. These are what I regard as the minimum security arrangements. As you can see, no one will be permitted to enter the prison buildings. There'll be a marquee set up in the garden, paid for from the recreation fund, and the entire prison staff will have to be on duty.
Well, they're not going to like that.
Probably not.
Well, what about the night shift afterwards? Obviously, they can't be on duty.
No, they must. If necessary, they'll have to work split shifts. We're dealing with the safety of small children.
Mr. Gillespie, I realise you've had vast experience with men's prisons, but a women's prison is rather different. The women would never harm a child.
How can you say that with a woman like Doreen Burns in here? She was convicted of kidnapping an 11-month-old baby.
But... very well. I'll have new work rosters drawn up.
Thank you.
Just wait a minute while I check if it's okay for you to come in.
But why?
Oh, you know, orders. It is Mr. Morris, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's ridiculous, these new security measures. Gillespie's making this place impossible.
Well, I suppose some of the inmates have always thought it was impossible.
Don't joke, Bob. I have to work here.
I'm not joking, and you don't have to work here. Ah, here we go.
You okay?
I think I'll just...
Hey, let me give you a hand there. That's quite a load you got on there.
You're rather late, Mrs. Jackson.
Well, yes, I've been shopping.
Shopping?
Yes, actually, I gave Mrs. Jackson permission to do some shopping. She's been buying some things for the pantomime.
Ah, I see. You must be Mr. Morris.
Yes, that's right.
Thank you for your help.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
Perhaps you'd escort Mr. Morris off the premises.
That won't be necessary. I know my way out.
Oh, we can't have you wandering round unescorted, Mr. Morris.
I'll pick you up after work, okay? From the outer gate.
Right.
Leave those, Mrs. Jackson. They'll have to be searched.
But surely you don't think I'd smuggle anything into the prison?
You weren't the only one carrying parcels in.
And neither would Bob.
One can't be too sure, Mrs. Jackson. After all, his daughter is an inmate of one of our prisons. Make sure all these parcels are searched thoroughly, Mr. Fletcher.
Yes, sir.
Jackson, could you tell me where I could find Mr. Fletcher?
Yes, in reception.
What's wrong?
Gillespie, that's what's wrong. I've just spent the morning searching the city for cheap material for the pantomime, and when I get back here, he insists on having it searched for contraband. He also accused Bob of being unreliable.
Yes, I'm sorry. Mr. Gillespie has the interest of the prison at heart. He just has an unfortunate manner.
Yes, well, I've had it. It's the last thing I do for the pantomime.
Oh, I'm sure Mr. Gillespie will be glad to hear that.
Why? What do you mean?
He wants the pantomime cancelled. He probably thinks if he makes life difficult enough for us, we'll give up on the idea.
And will we?
Well, I'm not.
All right, then. Neither will I. I'll help. Although I sometimes wonder whether it's worth the trouble Gillespie and people like him cause.
Attention, ladies. The material for your pantomime costume has arrived.
Oh, Butte, you want a hand bringing it in?
Won't be kept in here. They'll be kept in the storeroom, except when you're working on it.
Well, we should be working on it now. The panto's only a week away.
I'm sorry. All work's to be restricted to your recreation period. The dressmakers are to be locked in here. The rest of you will be in the recreation room.
Locked in?
To avoid rostering any extra staff.
Ah, to stop us from pinching stuff, you mean? Why would we want to pinch it when we practically paid for it with our own money?
I'm sorry, Smith, those are my orders.
Yeah, and I bet I know who set the order, too. Dizzy bloody Gillespie.
Just letting you hold this pantomime is a privilege. Obviously, there are going to be extra precautions taken. You're not the only ones involved. The staff are going to be involved in extra duties while the kids are here and while we're putting up the marquee.
Marquee?
Yes, the pantomime's to be held in the garden.
You mean they wouldn't even trust a few kids in the building?
Oh, of course not. I mean, they might steal something, mightn't they? Well, anything I've got there, welcome to.
Well, we've got nothing to pinch anyway.
It's not the kids they don't trust, it's us. They probably think we'd hurt them.